Agrians, or Agartians, a group of Asiatic or Nordic humans who, sources claim, discovered a vast system of caverns below the region of the Gobi Desert and surrounding areas thousands of years ago, and have since established a thriving kingdom within, one which has been interacting with other planetary systems up until current times. Alpha Draconians. Reptilian beings who are said to have established colonies in Alpha Draconis. Like all reptilians, these claim to have originated on Terra thousands of years ago, a fact that they used to justify their attempt to retake the Earth for their own. They are apparently a major part of a planned invasion which is eventually turning from covert infiltration mode to overt invasion mode as the window of opportunity, the time span before international human society becomes an interplanetary and interstellar power, slowly begins to close. They are attempting to keep the window open by suppressing advanced technology from the masses, which would lead to eventual Terran colonization of other planets by Earth and an eventual solution to the population, pollution, food and other environmental problems. Being that Terrans have an inbred warrior instinct, the Draconians do not want them, as to attain interstellar capabilities and therefore become a threat to their imperialistic agendas. Refer to Els. Altarians. Alleged reptilian inhabitants of the Altair stellar system in the constellation Aquila, in collaboration with a smaller Nordic human element and a collaborative Grey and Terran military presence. Headquarters of a collective known as the Corporate, which maintains ties with the Ashtar and Draconian collectives, Draconian, Ashtar Command. Amphibians. Similar to the Saurians or Reptiloids, yet being hominoid creatures with reptilian as well as amphibian-like features and are semi-aquatic in nature. May have once lived on land, yet became more aquatic over the centuries. They have been encountered near swampy regions, rivers, etc., and have been known to attack people without being provoked. It is interesting that some types of greys and reptiloids are believed to be semi-aquatic, having webbed fingers and toes. Anakim. Also referred to the Els, short for Elder Race or simply as the Giants. Referred to in ancient Hebrew tradition, this race is allegedly tied in with a branch of ancient humans who broke off from mainstream humanity because of their vast size which had developed over the centuries, possibly as a result of a genetic anomaly. They are said to range anywhere from 9 to 11 feet and in some cases even 12 feet in height, although in configuration they are remarkably similar to international humans. Are said to possess a means of molecular condensing and expansion which allows some of their kind to mingle among humans on the surface. They have allegedly been encountered in deep and extensive cavern systems below the western part of North America, as far north as Alaska, as far south as Mexico, and as far east as Texas. They are believed to have interstellar traveling capabilities. Andromedans. The Andromedan Council has ordered all extraterrestrial presences on the planet, in the planet, and on the moon to be completely out of our space. They want everything that CT, benevolent or not, off the planet. This will be very interesting since there are over 1,833 reptilians living in our planet and over 18,000 greys living underground and on the moon. The Council would like to see how we will live with each other when we are not being manipulated by ETs, as we have been for the last 5,723 years. Anunnaki. Nimrod was a worshipper of Anu. Nimrod, unlike Abraham, did not believe in an unseen deity. Nimrod wanted Abraham to worship Anu, the most high known as Elon Elon El. Nimrod was the founder of the city of Babylon, and his most renowned architectural influence was the construction of the Tower of Babel. Nimrod also had a city named in honor of Anu. It was to be called Calneh or Calneh, Genesis 10:10, meaning Fortress of Anu. It used to be an ancient city in Babylon, Mesopotamia. Calneh is often associated with Nippur, which is one of the seven cities that was inhabited by the agreeable Anunnaki. Nippur was also known as Kodesh. It was originally called Nibruki, meaning earth place of Nibiru. It was the city of Enlil, the Anunnaki Elohim, son of Anu and Antum. Not only was Kalna one of Nimrod's cities, there was Babel or Babylon, the ancient site and capital of Babylon near the Euphrates. Erech, a city 40 miles northwest of Ur, toward Babylon on the left bank of the Euphrates, and Akkad or Akkad, a city in North Babylon, and a part of the district around it are all a part of the land of Shinar, called by many the country of two rivers, literally meaning plains of the flatlands. In the land of Shinar, today called Iraq, is the place where the ancient Sumerians came to set up an advanced civilization, where you'd find pictograph cuneiform writings, excerpted from the Spell of Leviathan 666, Spell of King U, by Dr. Malachy Z. York. Antarctican. This is allegedly a secret area of operations for both human and reptilian beings. It is said by some that Aryan Nazi scientists actually developed disc-shaped aircraft capable of very advanced aerial performance, and that swastikas have been seen on a few aerial discs. They may be piloted by a purebred blonde, blue-eyed Aryan race. There appears to be more than one blonde human society involved in the UFO scenarios, and especially subterranean human societies may have developed blonde hair due to lack of sunlight. There does not seem to be anything more than a peripheral connection between the Antarcticans, the Tolosian and the Pleiadian blondes. That is, we will refer to the Antarcticans as the Aryans, the Tolosians as the blondes, and the Pleiadians as the Nordics, in order to discourage confusion. The Antarcticans may consist largely of batch-consigned purebred blue-eyed, blonde Aryans who became victims of Hitler's obsession to create a super race, and as suggested by Harbinson and others, most of these may be controlled through mind manipulation and implants, being human drones who are used to keep this hidden society functioning. A massive joint humanoid reptiloid underground system called the New Berlin is said to lie below the mountains of Neuschwanland, Antarctica. It is said by some sources that this joint human alien force has spread terror through this sector of the galaxy, conquering and committing untold atrocities against the peaceful inhabitants of other worlds. The famous abductee Barney Hill, who along with his wife Betty was abducted by Zeta Reticulum Greys in 1961, stated under regressive hypnosis that he had encountered an evil-eyed German Nazi working with the Greys on board the craft. It is claimed that the original treaty with the Greys was established by the Bavarian Thule and Illuminati societies as early as 1933, and this collaboration was brought into America via the CIA, which was established with the help of American Nazi Fifth Column agents, as well as European Nazis who were brought into America through Project Paperclip and other operations. Antares. Alien group that was affiliated with the Montauk Project, but only as observers. They look human. Arcturians. Arcturus is one of the most advanced civilizations in our entire galaxy. Edgar Cayce, further information here. Atlans. These are humans, usually described as being benevolent by comparison to other groups, who are said to inhabit vast and complex cavern cities beneath southern Brazil and surrounding regions. The term Atlantean or Atlan, in reference to these races, has been placed upon them because of the fact that these cavern networks along the east coast of Brazil were reportedly once a part of the antediluvian Atlantean Empire. The present inhabitants have no direct genetic relation to the ancient Atlantean society, which is said to have controlled these cavern systems several millennia ago, but are referred to as Atlanteans simply because they are descendants of those who rediscovered and inhabited the ancient Atlan installations. As in North America and other continents, both common and gnome-like humans have been encountered here, some of which possessed advanced aerial or disc technology. The Tolosians claim to have some connections with South America, especially the Mato Grosso region where a sister city named Posad exists in a large cavern system underground. Afin. They come from constellation Lyra. They call themselves Afin Spiensi. Small in stature and with blue spotty skin. Their planet is called Crimea AIP3. Their technical developed level is such that they can get here from their planet in only 20 Earth minutes. They do not need oxygen. A large percentage of their atmosphere is hydrogen. Colonize 10 planets in a non-violent way. When they are close to humans, they cannot be seen. Unless they want to. But humans will feel a certain amount of unexplained anxiety. Their spaceships are small and sphere-like. They visit us to study human deviation. This activity is important to them, in determining the further development of the human race. Alcabata. Aggressive race that comes from the constellation Perseus. They have over 5,000 ships, and have colonized 10 planets on their own. Considered one of the parasite races. Abduction of humans is frequent and ongoing. Purpose unknown. They do not like to interact with other alien races. Last seen on Earth, September 1, 2001 in Canada. Suspected to have been involved in several airplane crashes. Most known case, Korean Airlines Flight 007, over Russia, USSR, 1983. The Russians took the blame for it. Alamyuk Strat 163. They come from Jupiter. After a reputed lost battle in ancient India against Reptoids, exact race and date was not specified, they were forced to leave our planet, which they have been visiting for about 200 years. They have resumed their visit since 1948. As far as the book says, this race is technologically extremely advanced. Their ships, for the most part, are invisible and they also wear a suit that makes them invisible as well. Enana. This race are what we humans call Martians. They come from the constellation Gemini. For thousands of years, they have had bases on Mars, where they mine a sort of gold-like mineral. The first recorded visit on Earth was in 1235 BC, in Japan. According to the book, they were last seen on Earth in Madagascar in 2003. Algruulix. They come from the constellation Cetus, near Deneb Kaitos Shemli. Although they are often confused with reptilians, they do not share anything with the reptilians except the appearance. Their height is around 2 meters, 6 feet, and can live up to 350 years. This is one of 21 races that have more than two genders. This race have 8 different genders, and all of them can reproduce when in sexual contact with each other, no matter which. Their purpose to visit Earth is unknown. Last spotted in Lima, Peru, in December 2004. This race comes from the constellation Sextans. They crashed one of their ships, near the town of Vagina in Brazil. Achat. This race comes from the constellation Sextans. They crashed one of their ships, near the town of Vagina in Brazil, in 1996. Two of the occupants are under USA custody. They paid a huge amount of money for them. According to the book, they have the fastest ships among all alien races. Last seen on Earth February 2002, near Vagina in Brazil. Again. Eek. They come from constellation Ophiuchus, near Praia, considered by other races as peaceful. The purpose of their visits is unknown. They never stay long on Earth and do not interact with humans or other aliens here. They mostly use Earth as a stop, to quickly gather something they may need, before they leave to their real destination. They are mostly nocturnal. Their ships emit a bright orange light and are, most of them, not all, octagonal in shape. Last spotted near London, England, in May 2003. Alabram. They live on a planet that lies beyond the Andromeda galaxy. The beings on this particular planet have a similar physical appearance to us, but with great enlarged diaphragms and lungs. This is because the oxygen on this planet is so weak that an Earth person could not exist. This planet has millions of people on it like Earth. Their birthing process is different than us in that they carry the fetus for a shorter gestation period in their stomachs, and regurgitate it when the time for giving birth. At that moment the new baby is extremely small. It reaches full maturity in only 7 years. The beings on this planet have extremely large brains and are able to absorb information through osmosis, and are very telepathic. They drink liquid similar to water and live on foods that are grown in caves and tunnels hollowed out beneath the surface of the Earth. The reason for this is the star that serves as their sun is so hot that it would burn the plants if they were planted on the surface of the planet. Bavi. The inhabitants of the planet Bavi look like the typical blondes, and as such belong to the Lyran Caucasian group. In other words, they can walk among us without being recognized. Phenotype A1. On Bavi all human activity is concentrated in a metropolia, the rest of the planet being left to nature and to the animals which inhabit it. Men and women are on a footing of absolute equality, and have a lifespan which, though not unlimited, runs to several centuries. Their age is, so to speak, arrested when they attain their majority. Bernarians. Inhabitants of the Bernard's star system. Although not much has been written about them, it seems that human beings, at least in part, control this star system, along with the Orange. Whether the Saurians have any influence or not is uncertain, however some sources indicate a possible collaboration similar to that within our own solar system. Bootians, aka the Suleimani Confederation. They originated from constellation Boots, approximately 30 to 40 light years from Earth. They are malevolent towards humans. A part of the Orion group. Bootians are generally viewed as hostile towards the human. Physically, they are said to be chameleon or reptilian-like, and originated from the draconian reptilians. Bootians are allegedly quite intelligent, and have small snouts and large reptilian eyes. They eat human flesh because they view humans as a food source. Their negative activities include implantation, infiltration and control of galactic civilizations and societies, activities they are thought to be conducted here on Earth as well. Their reptilian heritage leads them to believe that they are the ultimate warriors, and that other races are inferior. One of their goals allegedly is to dominate the Earth entirely and are also working in deep underground bases on the Earth, working with the Draconians and Greys to take over the Earth. They have also exchanged advanced technology to the government. According to Alex Collier, the reptilian civilizations that we know today in boots are all genetic manipulated half-breeds of the original Chikaris. Burrowers. Another mutation of the saurian or serpent race that is capable of burrowing through the earth. Possibly quadrupedal as well as bipedal, these have been known to use their natural boring abilities to create artificial tunnels like moles, or even spontaneously produced cave-ins. The latter has allegedly been used in attempts to entrap or kill unsuspecting intruders into the underground domains. These may possess a highly developed biosensing system. Blue people. The blues are said to have translucent skin, large almond-shaped eyes and small of stature. The main issue of their teaching was pursue your passion, follow your own way, do your own thing, don't be pressured into being anything but what and who you are. The information about the blues comes from Robert Morningsky, a Hopi, Apache dancer. According to Morningsky, the first alien contact started about 1947 to 1948 with the Greys contacting the US government to form a treaty with them. Another body of aliens arrived, called the Blues. The Blues advised the government not to deal with the Greys, saying it would only lead to disaster. They told the US to follow your own path. They said they would teach with peace and harmony if men would disarm and listen. The military said no deal. So they left, but a few decided to remain and stayed in northern Mexico and Arizona and made a treaty with the Hopi Indians. These aliens are known by the Hopi as Star Warriors. The Greys started monitoring the Blues. So the Blues had to flee the reservation and go into hiding. A few of the elders went with them. The Hopi legend is that there were two races, the Children of the Feather who came from the skies, and the Children of the Reptile who came from under the earth. The Children of the Reptile chased the Hopi Indians out of the earth. These evil undergrounders were also called Two Hearts. Butters. Being that dwells in spiritual darkness. The person may be intellectually developed. The Butu are normally associated with nightmares, abductions and the taking of small children. They usually come around at night. The gray aliens who do abductions falls into this category. The reptilians are also part of this group. They are usually not very physically attractive. Apparently there was a visitation long ago by Butters, called Wakshashas, who were negative, powerful, aggressive beings. Sishans, or Tau Sishans. A human race of Mediterranean or South American appearing, tan-skinned humans. Very similar to Caucasian humans on Terra, except for slight differences. Slightly pointed ears, higher physical density for their size, slightly broader nose, 5 inches tall on average, and often wear short Roman or crew-style haircuts. Tau Ceti and Epsilon Eridani are said to be a major convergence of extraterrestrial human activity, and are said to be in alliance with the Pleiadians, who in turn, according to contactees, have federated alliances with the Vegans, the Amites, and others. The Sushan alliance with the Pleiadians and other societies who have been victimized by the Grey Predators, is based on a desire to establish a common defense against their reptilian nemesis. The inhabitants of Tau Ceti have been heavily involved in the war with the Lizzies. Interestingly, already in 1920, a contactee was told about the Norkans, a race of blonde inhabitants of a planet circling Tau Ceti, who migrated to Earth some 14,000 years ago. Tau Ceti is also one of the systems from which modern scientists have received clear radio signals that are believed to be an indication of intelligent life. Chameleon. Reptilians genetically bred to enable themselves to appear human. Also less humanoid appearing reptiloids who use a form of technosis, molecular shape shifting and or laser holograms to produce an outward human appearance. Reports of these have surfaced from underground joint operational facilities near Dulles, New Mexico, Dugway, Utah, Groom Lake, Nevada, Deep Springs, California, and Fort Lewis, Washington, and elsewhere. They are reportedly involved in some type of infiltration agenda. These infiltrators can appear remarkably human outwardly, however at the same time retaining reptilian or neosaurian internal organs. Often described as appearing bulge-eyed with scaly, hairless skin behind their disguise. One report alleged that the chameleons may utilize artificial lenses to conceal slit-pupilled iris. Some claim they are genetically bred mercenaries who are part of an advanced guard of a planned silent invasion takeover of human society. Chians. Physically, the average Chian is slightly taller than humanity, although they're more delicately built. Like the majority of species on their home world, the Chians are hexapods, possessing four legs and two arms. They have long narrow faces with a downward pointed muzzle, long fur stretches from their heads to mid-back. While their fur may naturally be brown, black or red, many dye their hair in intricate patterns. Although the home world of Chia is today a garden paradise, this was not always the case. Over a millennium ago, the Chians nearly destroyed their race and their world in a nuclear war. Huge swaths of land were irradiated, the seas blighted, and the whole planet slumped into a nuclear winter. The survivors of the war were those few who had survived in underground bunkers. The remaining Chians eked out an existence in sealed domes and underground bunker systems, as they worked over the course of centuries to restore their home world. Even today, many of the techniques used in modern terraforming efforts are a result of the Chians' experiences on their own home world. Diros. An underground species. Some believe them to be human while others see them as non-humans. These are the beings from which comes our legends of leprechauns and trolls. Unlike the Diros, this little beings are considered demented and cannot be trusted. The Diros try to keep them under control and keep them from having excessive power. The Diros live in underground tunnels, cities and under the sea. This group of insane cave dwellers were called Samonian, meaning the obese ones, or Samim, abandoned Diros, or as they are called today, Diros, which is a combination of the words detrimental and robots. These Samonians or Diros really exist. The chief is Yabuan. The Samonians are constantly in conflict with the group of beings called the Duanis, who hold the same belief, that they too will take over the planet one day. They are born by hatching from eggs that are 4 to 6 feet in diameter. They grow to 7 feet and are extremely obese. The Diros who live in the caves are degenerated so much, that they don't have much intelligence. They have a very complex structure of their skull. Visited Earth at least 20 times. They carry out human abductions which they use for human reproduction. They have abducted at least 520 humans, males and females. Dracos, reptilians. Location, home system, Alpha Draconis. Draco is the name of an astronomical constellation, of which Thuban is the alpha star. This constellation is the home of the Draconian Empire. Thuban is an Arabic word for snake. These are the most known and feared of the reptoid species. There are at least three. These are highly advanced entities but viewed as being of a negative, hostile or dangerous disposition since they regard humans as a totally inferior race. Supposedly they consider Earth their ancient outpost, and want to have complete control over it, because their planet is becoming unable to adequately support life. They are considered one of the most technologically advanced species, but they prefer to work in the shadows, using that as an advantage for their progress or plans, agenda. The highest order of the Draco caste is the white-skinned Draco beings. Some experiencers have reported seeing white-skinned Draco beings interacting with the greenish-brown-skinned Draco, reptoids and various grey types. In these cases, all other non-human entities, including other Draco, Greys and Reptoids, treat the white-skinned Draco as if they were their kings or generals. They can travel interdimensionally, most races can't, and some of their high-ranking members also have the power to become invisible. They have a presence on thousands of planets, and have at least colonized 500, by means of infiltration, within the leadership of each planet. They have three main bases on Earth, one near the Bermuda Triangle, one somewhere off the coast of Denmark, and one off the coast of New Zealand. Dorsey. They grow to a maximum height of 0.5 meters. They have visited Earth at least 250 times. They come from Cassiopeia, where they have two home planets. They eat other aliens as well as humans. Their race is at least 4 billion years old, and they have been in a constant state of war with another alien species for 2 billion years. Last sighting on Earth, November 2001, Italian Alps. Dries. Their height is around 2.5 meters. They have a very complex structure of their skull. Visited Earth at least 20 times. They carry out human abductions which they use for human reproduction. They have abducted at least 520 humans, males and females. They come from the third star in the constellation Cetus. They have two home planets and have colonized at least 40 planets, with the help of slaves. 10 of those planets were taken with use of force. They work together with three Ether races. They mostly eat animal protein-derived products. According to alien reports, they are not mentally, spiritually prepared to interact with most other races. Their home planet's chemical composition is similar to Earth. They are supposed to reveal themselves to humans in open manner in 2022. Elmanc. They come from constellation Grius, near the star Alnair. They are one of the most peaceful races. They co-created the Alliance of the Five Races, Council of the Five. The Council of the Five are a group of five aliens races that protect humans against less peaceful races. They coined the sentence, five universes, 2,500 species, one race. The council is supposed to meet in Earth during the last 10 days of August 2013, the reason being the fact that Earth has been receiving too many visits from new races in the past 500 years. Last sighting on Earth, near the Sea of Cortez, September 2002. Elfaf. They come from constellation Boots, near Acilus Primus. They also resembled the Greys, but are not related. This race has four different genders and they are known to be benevolent. The purpose of their visits is unknown, but they seem to have a special interest on raw materials, minerals, as they have been often sighted near old mines. Last sighting, San Isidro del General, Costa Rica, in 2005. Elena. Supposedly this is the race that started the myth of elves, elf. They are sighted often in the Germanic countries, deep in the forest. They are not known to be lethal to humans, however they are known as being pranksters. It seems that they are enjoying scaring humans when these get too close. It has been reported that they have lured humans away from their cars in order to steal their possessions. Once the humans are far away from their vehicles, and they already have stolen what they wanted, they frighten them, which makes the humans leave the location. Last sighting, near Muenchen, Germany, in December 2001. The Council of Five. The Council of Five is composed of the following races: Orela, Egaret, Chinvo, Ridden, Imather. Very little is known about the five alien races that are part of the Council of Five. It is generally agreed that the Imather is the most important race, not only to the Council but also amongst all known races. This race are related to the Solipsirei, but much older and advanced in all levels. They were one of the races who found the Council. They met with USA President D. Eisenhower in three different occasions. They also met with two high-ranking USSR leaders in three different occasions. They tried, without any force upon humans, to meet with USA President R. Nixon, but he refused, claiming that it would be too dangerous, as they maybe could read his mind and find out about delicate national security secrets concerning the relations with the USSR. The races that are part of this council, previously known as the Council of Nine, have been protecting Earth and the humans for as long as there are alien records of it. Some say that they have been protecting the planet even before humans existed, for millions of years. An alien race reported that the Council of Five last met on Earth in 1944. Note from Petro and myself, we found a handwritten note on the ARB dated July 2005 stating that the Council of Five is going to meet on Earth during the last 10 days of August 2013. The same note also mentioned the fact that the presence and arrival of those races could cause cosmic events that could affect Earth's atmosphere. It also said that humans would be seeing an increase of alien ships activity during this period. The note also states that the meeting of the Council is to discuss possible threats to Earth and humans, as well as the fact that so many new races have been visiting Earth lately. By lately, the note states that it means the past 500 years. According to several alien races, the Council of Five, at that time, Council of Nine, has monitored human evolution since primordial times, since humans were only a one-cell marine organism, and throughout all natural evolution, when humans became primate-like creatures and beyond, after the Anunnakin, aka Anunnaki interference. According to those same alien races, all evolutionary sequences in all planets have a beginning and an end, with exception of minor details due mostly to radical weather changes after the Anunnakin tampered with the DNA of primates and created humans. The Council of Five decided not only to monitor, but also to protect us, as they realized that one day humans would be able to join other alien races in development and enlightenment. X1Z. Only sighted two times on Earth. According to reports from other races, they are able to shapeshift as many as four times in 10 seconds. Their origin is unknown. They conduct human abductions and perform medical experiments on the subjects. They have been visiting Earth since the mid-1500s. They only confirmed sightings happened near Ilasik, Turkey. X5 Tikat. This race was created by the race Matra in order to be used as slaves. And that is what they still are being used as. They are often sent by the Matra to security-sensitive regions, working as messengers and also to conduct abductions. They can live forever as they are not organic. However, the raw materials that the Matra needs to build one are very rare, so there are not many of them, estimation, less than 300. They are able to use rational thinking, as well as flying ships and many other tasks. Last seen on Earth in July, 1997, near Brisbane, Australia. They have only contacted humans one time, in the USSR in 1935. They come from the galaxy UDFJ 39,546,284. Estimated distance from Earth, our standard, is 13.2 billion light years. According to reports, they were tall, had blonde long hair and smelled like flowers. They travel by using what other alien races call wormholes, which allows them to bend space. According to reports, they spoke some kind of Slavic dialect. They left a written message with about 10 sentences. Note from myself and Petro, on the original ARB, our copy slash edition, 9 of the sentences left by this race are blacked out. The only one that is not blacked out is the following. 2017 to 2022. The felines. The lion people. The felines are one of the two primary races in our universe. They arrived here by invitation of the founders. The overall feline temperament is warm, sanguine and intellectual. As they mature, they take on more of a somber, introspective and gentle nature. The elders are revered for their wisdom, compassion and insight. As part of the universal game, the founders gave the felines a new planet in the Lyra constellation for their home. The felines named it Avon. Now, this is not the exact pronunciation, nor spelling, but it is close enough. The real name cannot be translated into English. Their eye color ranges from blue to gold and can change from blue to gold as they mature. They also turn from a golden brown color to white. Devin, feline, is the reigning patriarch of the 9D Royal House of Avon, and Anu, human, is the reigning patriarch of the 5D Royal House of Avon at this time. Solipsirei, aka the Greys. They come from constellation Cygnus. Peaceful and harmonious race. They have one main leader and his name is Martin. Their civilization is 2 billion years old. The Giza people have been referred to by the Pleiadians, Billy Mayer contacts, as well as others. This may have some connection with the strange people and technology allegedly encountered in deep labyrinthine recesses beneath Egypt, who were sometimes reportedly seen by explorers, and who are said to dress like ancient Egyptians. There is allegedly, according to leading edge research, a huge cavern deep beneath Egypt which is inhabited by people with close ties with the US secret government. Some sources indicate that the Giza people may be a controlled society with the reptilians being the dominant power, although there is still much mystery as to what the Giza Empire is all about. Gracely. their height average is the same as that of humans, and are covered with soft silky hair. They have two home planets in the Virgo star system. They have visited Earth at least 12 times. Their first visit happened during the era, dynasties, of Egypt's pharaohs, around 3,000 years ago. They spent it 10 uninterrupted years there during that time. The Giza Pyramid was built in their honor. They have been keeping a close look at humans' development for the past 200 years, knowing that some powerful humans can, and are, being mislead by some alien races, disguised as humans. Their ships only contains 6 of them, while traveling. Last sightings, July 2002, and February 2004. Solipsirei, aka the Greys. They come from constellation Cygnus. Peaceful and harmonious race. They have one main leader and his name is Martin. Their civilization is 2 billion years old. Once they were at same level of development as ourselves. They have no colonies. They are completely focused on the development of other planets and races. They do have one powerful weapon, that keeps some neighboring violent races away. And others that may try to invade them. At one time race Matera lost 5 ships because of it. They said that the human race in the next few thousands of years, still has 645 options left to save ourselves, our planet and to guarantee a future for our race. But it will depend on our ability, to travel to space. They are Solipsirei, but humans call them, the Greys. The Invisibles. They come from constellation Mensa. This race is known to have been seen near high security areas. They are almost completely invisible to the naked eye. Both the US and Russian military have developed technology that allows them to track them down on radar, only the ships. 3 things are known all about this race. 1. They leave a sour smell when they are near. 2. When they are near windows you can see their reflection as a smudged-like figure, have been caught on CCTV footage. 3. When dogs start to bark with no apparent reason it is possible that they are nearby, or reptoids/reptilians. Purpose of presence, unknown. Eguanoids. Approximately 4 to 5 feet tall, with iguana-like appearance yet hominoid configuration. They have sometimes been seen wearing black hooded monk robes, or cloaks which conceal much of their saurian features, which include tails. These have been reported as being extremely dangerous and hateful towards humans and lesser-ranking reptiloids such as greys. And like all other branches of the serpent race, they utilize black witchcraft, sorcery and other forms of mind control against their enemies. They appear to be a dimension-hopping sorcerer or priest class among the reptiloid species. Endogdk, aka Tall Whites. This race has several bases on and in the moon, where they mine unknown materials. They use slaves to do most of their work. These slaves are extremely well taken care of, and the Endogdk see them as indispensable. Their operations on and in the moon are very secretive. They are in almost permanent contact with high-ranking officials, from the USA, China and Russian federal governments. They have the ability to shapeshift into an almost perfect human form. They are also known as Men in Black, as they use special dark suits to protect their skin when in human shape while conducting special operations on Earth. Gigantic. They come from constellation Horologium and are known to have allies with the race Matera. Maintains sporadic contacts with 3 Earth governments, but not the most powerful ones, not the US, Russia or China. Considered to have a violent nature by other races. They have been visiting Earth for 3,000 years. Last sighting, near Houston, USA, February 1st, 2003. Jafok. They come from constellation Indus. They are known by other races as peacemakers. They are very advanced technologically. Their first sighting on Earth dates back to 1500 BC. They met with JFK, 3 weeks before he was killed. They have also, around the same time, met with other human world leaders. They have not been seen on Earth since JFK's death. In 1965, they gave a message to the human leaders of countries with nuclear capability, content unknown. Kalnia. They come from constellation Aquila, star Taraised. They have colonized 3 planets, and have a lifespan of 150 years. They are often sighted in northern Africa, and the Sahara region. First visited Earth around 300 BC. They do not conduct abductions. Main interest about Earth, minerals. Last sighted in 2003 near a volcano in Iceland. Kilimatar, aka KR. They come from constellation Crux, near Gacrux. It is a very hard race to track down or spot. Both the US and the Russian military have developed a special camera and radar system that allows to spot them when they are on Earth. But even then, they have only been sighted 8 times. The purpose of their presence is unknown. When they are sighted, it is usually in the area known as the Bermuda Triangle. Killie Dockert. They come from constellation Vela, near the star Sahel al-Mulif. They grow up to 2 meters high, 6, and live up to 200 years. They can shape-shift, but there is one thing they cannot change, and that is the size and color of their eyes. They are one of the oldest known races. They do abduct humans. Last seen on Earth in July of 2008. Kurs. A.K.A. Gods of Lands. They come from the planet Delimons, believed to be related to the race Sain Unarchy. They are the race behind the story of Enlil and Ninlil. They were directly involved on the development of the human race during early stages. They spent time immersed in a precious gold-like liquid that presumably extends their lifespan. After centuries away from Earth, they have recently returned. Their own leader is amongst the most recent visitors. They will now stay on Earth permanently. They will have an important role in the years to come. Lyran. With its celestial keys, its chords of air, its frets of fire, the Samian's great Aeolian lyre, rising through all its 7-fold bars, from Earth unto the fixed stars. They come in all shapes, sizes, from dark-skinned to Caucasian. There is supposedly a red-haired, light-skinned giant race, with rather large features. Lyrans were evidently driven out of their star system several thousand of years ago, and relocated to many areas in the galaxy. The Lyrans were the original ancestors of our galactic family. Many thousands of years ago, their civilization reached a very high technological level, however fell into disagreement and factions within their culture. These factions went to war and destroyed much of their society. Many of these beings from Lyra left in their starships to colonize the Pleiades, the Hyades, and the Vega system. This region, like our own system, may still be a battleground between Saurian Greys and humans. Some of these Pleiadians of Lyrian ancestors also came to Earth during the Lemurians and Atlanteans period. These other civilizations could be looked at as our galactic cousins. Lang. They come from the sixth star, in the constellation Coma Berenices. They have 3 home planets, maybe 4, and have colonized at least 10. small species growing to 70 centimeters. They were one of the first races to visit Earth. This race started the stories about elves. Two alien races claim that they, Race Lang, have abducted over 10 million humans throughout history. That number is highly disputed. By two other alien races, they state that the number is much lower. And one race even made a statement to a Russian president, saying that the Race Lang has never abducted any humans. Last sighting, New Zealand, in 2006. A group of 20 members. Maitre. They have two home planets in constellation Megalpay. Same average height as humans. They are hermaphrodites, and their lifespan is 120 years. They have colonized at least 26 planets. Have abducted at least 5,000 humans, males. Abduction of humans is carried out openly. Are considered by many alien races as parasites. They have visited Earth at least 200 times. Visited Earth for the first time, during the prehistoric period, date unknown. They have the goal of colonizing Earth. That has not happened, because of protection from other alien races, such as the races from the Council of the Five. Last sighting, September 2006 near Nome, Alaska, USA. Movie Anton Kafik, aka Shining Ones. They come from constellation Vulpecula. They have met with at least two US presidents, as well as with USSR and now Russian leaders and some high-ranking officials. They supply limited amounts of their technology to humans in exchange for the freedom to conduct abductions. They do not involve other alien races in this process. They had a big role in Siberian and Tibetan culture. They have bases in those areas, hidden in the north face of the mountains. They have colonized over 40 planets outside our solar system. So far. Nordics. Blonde, blue-eyed, angular faces. Although Nordics are humanoid and externally almost identical to humans. Mitili. They come from constellation Serpens, star Allier. Once related to the Reptoids species, they are not, however, reptilians. First visit to Earth was only in June 13, 1965. They do not represent any threat to humans. Often seen around Antarctica. The reason for their visits is unknown. Last sighting, Antarctica, May 1, 1997. The Messengers. Probably the most enigmatic of all alien races. Not much is known all about them. They visit Earth around every 300 years. Their next visit is supposed to happen anytime now. They do not reveal themselves, and they do not make direct contact with humans. They leave carvings, drawings and writings on rocks, as well as symbols in historical monuments. Their ships have the shape of a teardrop, and are silver in color. Nagas. Also referred to as the Reptoids, Reptiloids, Reptans, Homo saurus, Lizard Men, or the Large-Nosed Greys. They play a significant role in the legends of India and Tibet, where they are considered by some to be demonical residents of a subterranean realm. They are described as being around 7 to 8 feet tall and of various colors, grotesque, but most often moldy greenish with scaled crocodilian skin. After a reputed battle in ancient times, between a pre-Scandinavian race from the Gobi region, and a reptiloid race based in Antarctica, the reptilians allegedly lost the battle for domination of the surface world, and were driven into underground networks in which they eventually developed aerial and space technology. A. The Nagas are said to have appeared at the birth of Gautama Siddhartha, who later became Buddha. B. The ancient well of Sheshna in Benares, India, is traditionally where the yoga aphorisms of Patanjali, a classical guide to students of yoga, was written. This well is said to be an entrance to one of the Nagas' underworld lairs. Nordics. Blonde, blue-eyed, angular faces. Although Nordics are humanoid and externally almost identical to humans, there are subtle differences in the Nordic alien physiology. Most of them are based on the living conditions. Their planets are extremely hot and dry, and have a low oxygen content in the atmosphere. They have a larger lung capacity than humans, and have a copper-based blood, in order to carry oxygen more efficiently. The eyes are protected by inner lids, and can allow them to see into the ultraviolet range of the spectrum. They have only 28 teeth, as they lack a back pair of molars. Their heads are longer than humans. Negamak, aka Nomopo. First known visit to Earth, happened only in 1989. They abduct humans and exercise control over the minds of their captives, which they use for their own benefit. After the captives release, reason unknown. They are also one of the oldest races. This is the race that most human governments fear when considering the future of humans. This race was the inspiration for the alien race in the movie Independence Day. Note from Petro and me. The ARB states the same thing about another race. The Orange. These entities largely converge beneath southern Nevada, northern New Mexico and possibly Utah. Some sources refer to 1. A human race with stark yellow, red or orange hair, others of 2. A genetically altered humanoid reptiloid strain or hybrid. They are often described as having a humanoid form, yet certain reptilian genetic features. They are also said to possess human-like reproductive organs, and possibly, or not, a human soul matrix, and therefore a divergent branch of the human race, or reptiloid race depending on which type of orange one is referring to. As some accounts suggest there may also be, 3. Orange-colored reptilians which possess no soul matrix. Refer to hybrids and hybrids. Some of the orange allegedly have connections to Bernard's star. These may also be the native Myrians, Saitku or Red Giants. In 1911, miners were digging out layers of bat guano from a cave, located about 22 miles southwest of Lovelock, Nevada, when they came upon the mummified remains, which would have stood 6.5 feet tall alive. The mummy was still crowned with distinctly red hair. The ancient legends of the local Paiute Indians described a race of red-haired giants, who were the enemies of many Indian tribes of the region. The Pleiadians. They come from solar systems, surrounding the Pleiades stars, more precisely from the planet Hera, near the star Tagata. They are associated with spiritual growth. They can grow up to 2.5 meters, 8 feet. They practice sex cultivation, the distinct difference between their sexual expressions and their sensual emotions. Their ships are known as beam ships. Although regularly visiting Earth, they have remained mostly silent since 10,000 BC. They are one of the oldest known races. They continue to develop the necessary mental skills to eventually reach their goal, higher spiritual state. Puritathilamu, aka Nozif 7. Their origin is unknown. They are often sighted in the northwest of USA, especially in the Oregon area. They have a special interest about Earth's oceans, and are known to have underwater ships. They are peaceful and mostly nocturnal. Last sighted in the year of 2000, near San Francisco, USA. Rack. Of the 58 races described in the book ARB, this is the race that least visited Earth, that we know of so far, only 5 times. They visited the area we know as the Middle East, and that created the belief in the jinn, or genies, in Islamic mythology. According to some Muslim scholars, they inhabit an unseen world, in a dimension beyond the existing dimensions of our universe. According to reports from other alien races, they stopped visiting Earth because their immune system could not cope with Earth's fauna and flora. Last recorded visit, 712 AD. Rumei. They come from Capella, constellation or Iga, known to be a very peaceful race. They tried to coexist with humans. They created the Mayan civilization, culture, by placing humans from different places on Earth, in South America. They are a race of scientists. They taught the Mayans about astronomy and time. They left Earth when the Mayans were at their highest splendor. After that, the Mayans started their well-known blood sacrifices, in honor of Rumei. Last sighting, Bora Bora in 2001. Smad. They come from planets folk, constellation Bat-Terae. Their ships have a conial shape. They resemble humans in appearance. According to one alien race, they have only 6 ships left. They colonized 20 planets, 18 of them were inhabited. First visit to Earth happened 2,500 years ago. They are very interested in our religious beliefs. They are a race in decline, weakening, according to other races. Strom. They come from constellation Ursa Minor. Stroms are invertebrates and coelenterates. Their average height is 2 meters. Vegetation is of great importance to their culture, and main reason for their visits to Earth. They have been on Earth at least 200 times. They act with extreme caution, and are rarely seen by humans. First visited Earth, at the end of the last big ice age. They have 20 colonies in the Violacta galaxy. Their ships have the shape of an octagon. Last sighting, October 1976 in Oregon, USA. Syrians, or Sar.am. The Syrians were seeded, and evolved much later than the Aryans. It's a significantly younger star race, but much older than mankind. In their basic biokind, they are apparently a wolf, reptilian species, but also with cat-like features. Both females and males have golden brown, dark, or red manes. Their ancestors, from whom this star race was genetically engineered, were wolf-cat-like creatures, which seem to have been a blend between a dog, wolf, a cat, and a reptile. This is where we get the name Dog Star for Sirius, from the word dog stemming from the Aryan word dak, pronounced similar to the German word dock. Our ancestors were well aware of the origins of these star visitors, and where they came from. We can sometimes get a hint of how they looked like in the Sumerian tablets as well, although the bodies they used here on Earth, and still do, are not really their original bodies, but were genetically manipulated and cloned to blend in better with the human societies of the time. Taris. Their origin is unknown. They are often seen near or flying by volcanoes. Identified due to the exquisite nature of their ships, they have never contacted humans, and there are no reports of violence or abductions. Even though they are discreet in their presence on Earth, they do not try to hide from view. There are several contradictory reports about their appearance. Last sighted, off the coast of Norway, in 2000. TSAR-3. Their origin is unknown. There are reports stating that it takes them near to Earth years to get to this planet. They are the survivors of an extinct reptoid race, and do not possess the same level of technology and knowledge as other races visiting the Earth. They have some human characteristics, such as skin. In 1977-78, near Siena, Italy, two of their species were captured, after landing behind a church in ruins. 3 days later they were transferred to a US air base, still in Italy, and finally taken to an undisclosed location where, supposedly, they still remain. Contacts have mentioned somewhere in the South Pacific, or in another US base near Japan. The USSR APIS-3 was able to get hold of one video recording of this species. Last sighting, January 3, 2001, near Victoria, Canada. Tengri Tengri. They come from planet Tengri, Galactic Sector 56, Star System F1342. They live underground and have a population of 10 million. First visit to Earth, 10,000 years ago. They do not need an atmosphere or water to survive. They have one ship that can accommodate 5 million of their kind. They have had contact with human governments throughout history. Last known sighting, near Buenos Aires, Argentina, 2003. As one of their interests, or area of study, to see how other races react to tragedies and catalysts, one alien race reported that they, the Tanzani, caused both crashing of the Hindenburg, as well as the sinking of Titanic. They are of Tanzani. They come from constellation Perseus, near the star Gorgonia Secunda. They can live up to 500 years and are around 1.7 meters tall. Technologically they are extremely advanced. They have caused thousands, maybe millions of deaths on Earth and other planets, as one of their interests, or area of study, to see how other races react to tragedies and catalysts. One alien race reported that they, the Tanzani, caused both crashing of the Hindenburg, as well as the sinking of Titanic. They are avoided by other races. Last sighting, January 1999, in New York. Talosian. Tall, blonde inhabitants of a re-established network of subsurface antediluvian colonies located throughout the western states and concentrated around Mount Shasta in Northern California. They are sometimes referred to erroneously as Lemurians, as it is believed that the cavern cities which they rediscovered and built upon were once part of an antediluvian civilization called Lemuria, Elamu. They may have loose contact with the Pleiadians and other groups via ancient ancestral ties, since the Telosians are Earth natives who allegedly possess interstellar vehicles, and are a western branch of the sub-international Agati network and its silver fleet. The name Telos is a Greek word meaning uttermost or purpose, yet some of the inhabitants refer to ancient ties with Neo-Mayan tribes, and therefore many of them may possess a Greco-Mayan ancestry. Some ancient Vedic texts speak of a collaboration between the Greeks and the East Indians, who some believe gave rise to the Mayas, in the development and construction of aerial craft called Vimanas. Telosians are part of a Melchizedek spiritual order with connections to the Ashtar collective mind, and have dealings with extraterrestrials in Arcturus, Sirius, and Saturn, as well as with other dimensional beings. The Taros. Taros, which is short from integrative or constructive, are a subsurface race that usually keep the Taros in check. The Taros were the original tribe of the Lunarians, who came to this planet to dwell beneath the surface of the Earth. They are referred to as the Sunanans, meaning the yearly ones. The Taros were for disagreeable people, and the Taros were for agreeable people. Their chief is named Lamza. The Taros came from the planet Jomon, in the star constellation Arcturus, which is in the Boots constellation. Arcturus, the red giant, the fourth brightest star in heaven, is where much mixing took place. The Sunanans have 48 chromosomes instead of the normal 46 that Earth people possess. The Taros' chromosome structure is so different from Earthlings, that when mixed with certain humans, it caused a defect of 47 chromosomes, which today is called Down's syndrome. Their children are usually born with breathing defects, as well as congenital heart disease, and they also have poor digestive systems. Their immune system is unable to function properly, and they are more prone to developing leukemia. The Taros that have an abundance of pigmentation in their skin are descendants of the Shuiyuk. Those who are lacking pigmentation are descendants of the Halobeans, Flagellords or Hulub. The Taros bored further into the earth, and were able to keep their sanity. Because of crossbreeding, the Taros took on different forms. Some look so human they can come to the surface and not be noticed. Most of the legends of leprechauns and trolls derive from this species. The Umites. Humans claiming to hail from the general area of Wolf 424, some 14 plus light years distant from the Earth's Sol system, and possibly having ancient ties with the Lyran colonies in that the Umites from the planet Umo are like the Lyrans Pleiadians said to be Scandinavian in appearance, and therefore may tie in with the so-called Nordic or Blonde societies. They reportedly work closely with the vegan humanoids. Vegans. Relatively peaceful and gentle humans, descended from refugees from the Lyran Wars, who work closely with other refugee colonists, now living in the Pleiades, Wolf 424, and elsewhere. Often described as dark-skinned Orientals, similar to the native residents of the nation of India. Vega was one of the first Lyran civilizations to develop a unique and cohesive identity, which assisted in seeding and colonizing many systems, including Altair, Centauri, Sirius and Orion. Physical characteristics of the Vegans. A. Standard vegan, 6 to 7 feet tall, darker skin, sometimes copper-toned, non-Caucasian, black hair, very large eyes with dark pupil and iris, and one lid. Blood is green. B. Non-human type vegans, humanoid or mammal, yet their appearance is more insect-like or reptilian. Their skin is dark, sometimes even with a green or brownish tinge. Venusians. There are many stories about inhabitants of Venus. Surface colonies allegedly exist in biodome cities, whereas still other reportedly live in the antimatter, counterpart of Venus, which in the alternate universe is part of a 12-planet alliance, called the Cold Asian Alliance according to some contactees. The Pleiadians also claim to have colonized the antimatter universe, which they call the Dull Universe. One of these races that are said to live on Venus are the Hatha, mentioned by Bob Frisle. They are a fourth-dimensional race. Another race of Venusian origin is mentioned by Dr. Daniel Fry in the White Sands Incident. The Gnors are said to be an etheric higher-dimensional race. When they choose to take physical shape, they look like Earth's Nordic races. They supposedly are one of the eldest races in our solar system, and are members of the Galactic Council. The Gnors no longer inhabit Venus. Vinivori. They come from constellation Pavo, and are vegetarians. They are a very respected and peaceful race, presumably with mystical powers. They have come to Earth at least since 1000 AD. They can live up to 2000 years. Their height is similar to that of a normal human. Last sighting, near Odessa, Ukraine in July of 1995. Zeta Reticuli, aka Shampala. Often confused, because of their appearance, with the races Matre and Solipsirei, the Greys. They come from constellation Nets. They are allies of the Anunnaki, and cooperate with them on different planets. They are representatives of the Anunnaki on Earth, and send them information about humans and this planet, at least 25 times per year. The Anunnaki created a subspecies of the Zeta, with the purpose of making them look more human-like, but leaving enough physical differences for humans to distinguish them. They became some of the pharaohs of Egypt. The most well-known was Akhenaten, who was removed from power by reptilians. They infiltrated themselves in the court as temple priests. First reports of Zetas on Earth go back to 4000 AD. But that number is most likely higher. They were the first hybrids to be engineered by the Anunnaki. The Zeta subspecies still exist on Earth and still, at least 30% present the same physical differences created in them. The sexual organs of the subspecies are in every aspect, the same as that of humans. Their Zetas still exist on Earth in both forms. The original and the hybrid subspecies. Their location on Earth is unknown.
Can you feel it? A sort of anticipation growing stronger and stronger? Another way of putting it is time is speeding up. I've heard that discussion for a while now. I know most people have felt it at some point, maybe while watching the news or perhaps something in their own lives. Something big is about to happen.